In this video, we will show you the parts of the nitrogen rack and how to use it to perform a reaction under nitrogen. The nitrogen rack has multiple parts in it that make sure that it works. First of all, here at the bottom is your connection for the nitrogen from your fume hood, and on the other side, there's the connection for vacuum from either the vacuum pump or from the vacuum line in your fume hood. We'll go first through the pathway of the nitrogen. So the nitrogen comes in here, and then there's a pressure reduction that makes sure that the pressure of nitrogen is always slightly above one bar, but not so high that it will blow your reaction. Then the nitrogen will go through this line into this column of P205 on ice, P205 with a blue indicator, or called secapent. And on the top, it's already blue, but on the bottom, it's still white. If it turns completely blue, that means that doesn't dry your nitrogen anymore, and you have to replace the P205. Then, after that, it will go through this line into this bubble counter, and here you will see bubbles forming that proves that there is actually gas flow through the system. And then, at the bottom here, it connects to this double manifold, which you can connect to your reaction. The double manifold is also connected with an extra pipe to this overpressure valve. So for example, if your reaction produces gas, the overpressure valve will release that pressure, so there will be no pressure buildup in your reaction. The other thing that is attached to the double manifold is your vacuum, so vacuum pump or the vacuum line from your system, and that's on the front side of your manifold. And you can use these tabs to connect either vacuum or nitrogen. So to show how this works, here we have one of the tabs, and you can see that there's two lines. So one that goes, if you rotate like this, will connect the front to the bottom part. If you rotate it the other way around, it will connect the front to the top part. So, and if you then rotate one side, it will connect to the nitrogen, and if you rotate it to the other side, it will connect to the vacuum. It's always a good idea to test which side of this tap is nitrogen and which side of the tap is vacuum before actually attaching it to your reaction. And now we will show an example setup with the nitrogen rack in the fume hood. So here we have our setup, a simple three-neck flask with a stirrer and a male adapter connected to the nitrogen rack. And we will show you how to connect this under in an atmosphere. If your reaction requires you to do it under dry conditions, make sure you dry your glassware in the oven overnight and leave it to cool down under vacuum. So now we will show you how to cycle the nitrogen in vacuum line to make sure that your reaction is properly under nitrogen. So this is the nitrogen rack I just showed you, but now it's connected to the nitrogen from the fume hood, the vacuum from the fume hood, and here it's connected to our system. So first, we need to check if the system is actually working. So everything is connected, our nitrogen line is on, and the first check we want to do is to see if there's no bubbling when everything is closed, because if it would be bubbling now, it means there's a leak somewhere in this system and you need to get it fixed. As you can see, no bubbling, so our system is now airtight. And to double check that actually everything is working and which side of the tap is nitrogen and which side of the tap is vacuum, we can just test an open line. So first I will rotate the black one down, and you see that it starts bubbling. And if I feel with the back of my hand, I actually feel an airflow, which means that the nitrogen is now coming out. And if I close the tap, you can see that the bubbling stops. If I rotate to the other direction, you will hear the vacuum, and if I put my finger on top of it, it will suck and close. So this is the vacuum. So now we know which side of the tap is what, and all taps are labeled in the same way, so this is also the same way for this. So the black one is nitrogen, not labeled is vacuum. So we have our system and our nitrogen. So now we're going to cycle the system on the vacuum and nitrogen to make sure that all the air in the system and all the moisture in the system is gone. And to do that, we first put our reaction, our empty flask, on the vacuum. So not with your reagents in there or solvents in there, because they will start boiling immediately if you put it on the vacuum. So don't add any of your chemicals, but first put your flask on the vacuum. The bigger the system is, the longer it will take to go to full vacuum. If you use a pump, you will hear the pump change pitch when it's done sucking the full vacuum, or you can check the monitor of the in-house system to see if the pressure is stable again. When it's stable, you can close the tap and slowly open it towards the nitrogen for it to fill with nitrogen again. You don't open it immediately, because if you open it at full force, then you have a full system on the vacuum and it will connect to the nitrogen line and will pull a lot of nitrogen in, and sometimes your bubbling will break because the oil will go all over the place. You can slowly open it further. You can see vigorous bubbling now. And then we put it under full nitrogen until the bubbling stops. If the bubbling would remain bubbling very vigorously, it would mean that there's a leak in your system. And to prevent leaks from systems, the best thing is to grease all your joints to make sure that there's no leaks. As you can see here, there's no bubbling anymore, so there's no leak in my system, or very tiny amounts of bubbling, and it's completely filled with nitrogen. And we'll cycle this another two times. So back to vacuum. And when it's at full vacuum, you go back to filling it to nitrogen. As you can see now, the bubbling almost stopped. So we'll close it back and then go back to vacuum. And when the system is fully on the vacuum, we will do one last cycle and fill it up with nitrogen again. And now we have our reaction flask under nitrogen, and we replaced all of the oxygen in there, and we can start a reaction under nitrogen and under inert atmosphere. This would also work with argon or other gases that are not normally in air. If you are going to add compounds to your flask, make sure you always do it with the nitrogen tap open, so that no oxygen can get into your flask. And if during the reaction this white sycophant turns blue, then you will have to replace the P2O5. Well, you can't do it during the reaction, but when you're done with your reaction, replace it with new dry sycophant and destroy the old sycophant on ice, which is also labeled on multiple places on the nitrogen rack, because this is phosphoric acid and it will react heavily with water. So always destroy it on ice and then throw it away. This is how you perform a reaction under inert atmosphere.